My husband. I still cannot get used to calling him my husband. He had been everything else for me. Someone who listens and never judges, who makes me laugh, and pick on me every chance he got. Until one day, he became my husband. When I woke up that day, I knew that something was different. I woke up to a day that marks the starting point of my life. A day when I became responsible for someone other than myself or my parents. That day, I committed my heart, my mind, myself to another person. It sends shivers down your spine, you know, when you hear it out loud, that a man, your best friend, swore an oath that he wants to love you for as long as he shall live, to make your life his life. That day, two souls became one, and two big families became one ridiculously big family. It was a day with endless laughs and happy tears. It was beautiful. Perfect. The funny thing is, although we put so much energy and importance on our wedding day, it isn't the biggest day of our life. It's not. The biggest days are every day after. The ones that start with waking up to him on my side, with his messy hair and funny face. Because it's not the promise, but the act of fulfilling that promise consistently is what matters most. To make sure that he wakes up every day knowing that he's loved, that no matter how bad life gets, we'll never quit on each other. I'll never quit on him.
Menurut Mama, pernikahan itu adalah janji yang harus kamu tepati. Harus saling menyayangi, harus saling membahagiakan, saling mengalah, saling memberi dan menerima. Itu arti sebuah pernikahan menurut Mama. Duh, sim sabar. Harus nurut sama suami. Harus selalu sayang ya sama mama, sama ayah. Jangan tinggalin mama. Ya.
Being married is not easy. But one thing made it all worth it. The feeling when you know that you are so much loved. That someone puts you in his priorities even before himself. That he will do whatever it takes to make my dreams come true. That's my husband. And this is our marriage, the one that we'll cherish every day till forever.